Regent's Park, London, 11 a.m. on a Tuesday in November. The end of the Muslim month of fasting and the day of the festival of Eid. Outside, the swinging London of the 70s, indifferent to, almost at home with, this Asian phenomenon in its midst. Now, 5,000 followers of Islam picking their way through the dead leaves of a late autumn to a makeshift mosque of marquees. The first time I saw Regent's Park was in November 1949, when, as a fresh arrival from India, on demob leave from the army, I picked my way among the dead leaves of World War II. People from India and Pakistan, I remember, were comrades in arms with the British at that time. The memory of war was harshly fresh. An Asian was someone from the regiments of the legendary Indian Army, the 11th Sikhs, the 1st Punjab, the 2nd Gurkhas, a partner in a victorious war effort, an ex-subject of a still glowing empire. But when the rate of immigration increased, when the pinch came in the 50s and the pressures mounted in the 60s, that wartime comradeship was forgotten.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the Merciful, the Compassionate. Praise be to Him. During these years, I had to watch my own people becoming objects of bitterness. Loyal subjects of an empire became intruders from foreign lands who had come to usurp England's jobs and houses to prepare a bed in which future rivers of blood would run.
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
But the families of Asia stuck together and survived. They survived because they remained a family, and because the strength of their faith did not allow them to become embittered and prejudiced against those who rejected them. They learned to adapt to the laws and customs of the country that accepted them. They do not live apart from British society today. They simply retain and practice their own customs within it.